If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you. Streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place out there for people like you.
Oh, some wonder. scripture reading is taken from Revelation 21 verses 1 to 7. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of the heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be with his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he said that, sat upon the throne, said, Behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, Write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said unto me, It is done, I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, and will give unto him which is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things,
Hi.
And I will be his God, and he shall be my son.
Hi everybody, happy Sabbath. I hope everybody's doing just fine. And as you all know, I am here to sing. And so I'll be doing the song, Mercy Says No. I was just a child when I felt the Savior leading. I was drawn to what I could not understand. For the cause of Christ, I had spent my days believing that what he had me be is who I am. As I come to see the weaker side of me, realize the disgrace is what I mean. Sin demanded justice for my soul. Mercy says no, I'm not gonna let you go. I'm not gonna let you slip away. You don't have to be afraid. Mercy says no. Sin will never take control. Life and death stood face to face. Darkness tried to steal my heart away. Thank you, Jesus. Mercy says no, no. For God so loved the world that he sent his son to save us. From the cross he built a bridge to set us free. But deep within my heart, there is still a warmth that reaches and makes the sacrifice so hard to see. When midnight fades on crucifixion day, though light of hope seems oh so far away, when darkness tried to steal redemption's goals, mercy says no. I'm not gonna let you go. I'm not gonna let you slip away. You don't have to be afraid. Mercy says no. Sin will never take control. Life and death stood face to face. Darkness tried to steal my heart away. Thank you, Jesus. Mercy says no. And now he never looks at me. It's through the blood of Jesus, reminding me of one day long ago. Long ago, mercy says no. I'm not gonna let you go. I'm not gonna let you slip away. You don't have to be afraid. Mercy says no. Sin will never take control. Life and death stood face to face. Darkness tried to steal my heart away. Thank you, Jesus. Mercy says no, no. Mercy says no. Thank you. Have a great day. Have a great day in Christ. And never lose hope. Mercy says no. Bye.
This is a remembrance of the late Beverly Edwards. Beverly Edwards, affectionately called Auntie Bev by the children and teachers alike, was a very warm and friendly person. She joined the teaching staff of Miracle Kindergarten in September of 2018 as a caregiver for the three-year-old class, but she was also a kind and friendly teacher to all three classes of children. Whenever a child was sad, they would cuddle to her arm and find it a welcoming pillow. She was a very good teacher and did so well with the children in her care. However, life has its challenges, and Auntie Bev had her fair share. At some point in time, she had to go to the hospital for her checks. On the 16th of February, I went into Kingston. On my return, I met her at the school gate, going home. She said, "Miss Hall, I feel so weak. I feel like I am catching the flu." I encouraged her by saying, "Auntie Beth, take care of yourself, because you will not be able to fight Miss COVID." Because of this, she was absent from school for a little while. When I called to check up on her, she said she was feeling better and would soon come back to school. However, after church the following Saturday night, her condition got worse after being exposed to the night air. She did all she could to take care of herself. During my frequent checkups, I encouraged her to go and see the doctor. She was eventually transported to the hospital and admitted. I prayed and hoped for the best. We all prayed for her speedy recovery. On the 11th of March, I called to check up on Auntie Bev as usual and was advised by one of her close family that she had passed. It was a very sad moment for me, as I was looking forward for all of us to be back in the face-to-face environment, interacting with our children. But for now, I can only say, we cannot, Lord, thy purpose see, but all is well that's done by thee. Shamar, I encourage you to be strong and hold on to Jesus and never let go his hands. He knows what is best and just what to do. She will be sadly missed by the school and church community. The Zone 10 Fellowship, ILS teacher, discovered B cluster. All the children in the community whose lives she has touched, and host of friends and relatives. Rest in peace, Auntie Bev. until we meet again.
Okay, in loving memory of my dear friend, colleague, church sister, Beverly Edwards, affectionately called Auntie Bev, and to some, Sister Bev. I would refer to her at times as Fluffy Viva. She would laugh, and she would do this, a movement, a dance like this. Which I call the diva dance. Because this she would do every time I mention Fluffy Diva. Because of her positive energy and the desire to sing, we became very close friends. Some would say like Psyche and Trim, because you would see us singing together many times. Time after time, as I was impressed, I would just pick up my phone and give her a call and pray for her and give her some word of encouragement. This she would say after, Miss Curtis, me tell you, say, you know, you can prophesy, you know, Miss Curtis. Me tell you, you can prophesy, man. Make God use you, man. God want use you. And I would just laugh. Yes. She was a jovial, dramatic, but stern when it's time to teach and for learning. This was her passion. She was full of surprises. She brought fun and creativity to life in all its form. She joined the Miracle Kindergarten staff 2018. Over these past year, she made a great impact on the lives of the children of Miracle Kindergarten. Her 3-year-olds were the spotlight for graduation 2019, where she taught them and they said 84 words from memories. This was shocking to many. She was also a person of interest, great interest in her community, where she taught children from the community. She had many children who were successful in their GSAT and CXC. She was well known for teaching. Before the COVID, she would not miss out. She would not miss out on any prayer meeting we had around the church. She was indeed a sweet soul. May her soul rest in peace. To the Edwards family, I am so sorrowful for your loss. She will be sadly missed.
Lord, I pray on your name, you lead your mercy. Whenever I fall, you lift me up. Glory to me, oh God.
Our dear most saving grace, I know I'm not worthy to see your face. I try hard, but I make mistakes. You're still by my side every step that I take. To every ache, are you getting prayed? Are you on my guide and shield always? Every time I give and I pray all day, you still show me mercy and keep me safe.
Thank you.
Lord, I pray. On your name, deliver your mercy. Whenever I fall, you lift me up. Glory to thee, O God. Auntie Ben, your life was a blessing, your memory a treasure. You are loved beyond words and missed beyond measure. Sleep in peace, Auntie Bev.
A tribute to Auntie Bev entitled Until We Meet Again. The special memories of you will always bring a smile. If only I could bring you back for just a little while. Then we could sit and talk again just like we used to do. The fact that you are no longer here will cause me some pain. But you are forever in my heart until we meet again. Rest in peace, Auntie Dev.
Thank you, everyone, for sticking around. I must bring greetings to everyone on behalf of our church pastor, Pastor Romaine Richardson. He sends his love to the family. Also, Pastor Carl Cunningham, who's the personal ministry director of the East Jamaica Conference, he also sends his condolences to the bereaved family. We'll have the greetings from the district elders. So we'll take Mavis Vang first, Hagley Gap, Content Gap, and Ginger Peace, and then we will have a tribute from the Mavis Bank Seventh-day Adventist Church Youth Department.
Let me say pleasant. I was about to say pleasant Sabbath. My earliest memory of Sister Bev goes back to the 90s, early 90s, when I came to Mavis Bank to participate in a concert. She was one of the most outstanding individual in Mavis Bank Seventh-day Adventist Church, and still was until she passed. This afternoon, I am here to represent the Board of Elders from the Mavis Bank Seventh-day Adventist Church. Want to say to the members of the Edwards family that our prayers are with you. Hope, and we pray that as we contemplate the joy and the peace of heaven, as the Apostle Paul reminds us that we should not mourn like those who have no hope. So as we think about the future life, as we think about the life after, let us not mourn as if Sister Bev has gone to some other place where it is just sorrows and all of that. God has done what's best for her. And so I want to say, personally, as one of the elders, my prayers has always been with you, and we hope and trust that as we continue on the path of righteousness, that God will prepare us for his glorious appearing. God bless you.
On behalf of the membership of the Hagley Gap Seventh-day Adventist Church, I express my sympathy to the family of Sister Edwards. We will continue to pray you up so that God will give you the strength to remain strong. Today, we are here to celebrate the life of Sister Beverly Edwards, who was a phenomenal woman, a woman of strength, who was not afraid. She showed courage in the midst of fear. Sister Bev was an outgoing person who was very supportive. Her presence was always at Hagley Gap Seventh-day Adventist Church whenever we had special celebrations, or if she was led by the Spirit to come over to Macedonia and sing. Many hearts were touched by her ministry. We will cherish those memories of her, and she will always be in the hearts of the Hagley Gap brethren. Personally, I have precious memories of her assisting me with my special needs daughter, Susie, when she was at Rhonda Lopez School of Hope. She would take Susie to Papine, put her on a bus, and called me to receive her. She was a mother, and Susie experienced that motherly attention, so she referred to her as Mummy. She was always Mummy whenever she saw her. Then she would get so excited and say, Mummy, 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 Mummy. So at this time, we want to say, Sister Bev cannot hear us now, but we are saying goodbye, Sister Bev, Auntie Bev, goodbye, Mummy. Rest in peace until Jesus comes.
Good evening, everyone. It's indeed a very sad moment for all of us, especially to the families of Sister Edwards, the church family, immediate church family, Mavis Bank, the friends, loved ones. On behalf of Content Gap, Seventh-day Adventist Church, and my family, immediate family, we want to express our deeper, sincere condolences to the families of Sister Bev. It was just a few months ago, Sister Bev and I was in the process of setting up from Content Gap side a tribute on behalf of our aunt Gertrude. And who would believe that now, on this side, we are doing the same arrangement for Sister Bev. It saddens our heart, but as it is that God understands and He's standing by. Sister Bev had a broad smile, and if one will say, not just a broad smile, Sister Bev was a large person. You could miss Sister Bev. The smile and the shape, they just enhance each other. Sister Bev, to me, was quite a jovial person, one who loves to sing. If it's normal song service, and you go to Mavis Bank Church, Sister Bev will be singing. If it's the choir, Sister Bev. If it's special, Sister Bev. Funerals, crusade, and even invitation to the district churches, Hagley Gap, Content Gap, Ginger Peas, and the special, the Mavis Bank group is asked to present a special. The special is not going to be completed unless Sister Bev is involved in it. To me, she plays a pivotal role in the singing department in Mavis Bank Church. We went to District Fund Day, our Miracle Fund Day down at Church Gate, and in the music department, whether it be the selecting group or the part that uses the mic, Sister Bev is the one is there that will be kicking up that vibe, so to speak. So Sister Bev will be sadly missed. We pray that things would have been right with her and her God. And on the same part, we hope that we will have things right with our God so that we will meet up together again. Oh brother, oh sister, be faithful. Soon Jesus will come.
Good day, everyone. On behalf of the Ginger Peas Seventh-day Adventist Church, I too would like to join with the Lilsbang District of Churches in sending condolence to the family of the late Beverly Edwards. Indeed, the district has lost a stalwart. She has been a wonderful, wonderful person on the scene while she was here with us. We would have seen her coming to Ginger Peace, sharing, participating in our various programs and happenings, not to mention the beautiful voice that she would have had, been blessed with by our God Almighty. She utilized it with such power and clarity with the Mavis Bank Church Choir in bringing across messages to help to instill and to motivate and to encourage our brethren, not only at Ginger Peace, but I'm sure across the entire district of Mavis Bank Circuit of Churches, and also wherever else she would have gone. She is a wonderful friend, a wonderful person, a great personality. We are going to miss her immensely, and we join with the family at this point in time as we share in the grief, not sharing like those without hope, but sharing like those with hope, because she would have lived the life that Christ would have wanted her to live. And we hope that by God's grace, on that great getting up morning, she will be a part of the great number to make it into the kingdom of heaven. And so we encourage the family to remain strong, remain hopeful, and remain steadfast in Christ. And also to the church, I want to implore us to join with the family and join with every member across the district and say to the family, we are here for you, to support you and to stand with you during this time of grief. On behalf again of Ginger Peace Seventh-day Adventist Church, we want to say to everyone, God bless you. Continue to be strong in the Lord. And when he comes, may he find all of us faithful in his sight. And we too can make it to heaven when he comes. God bless you.
Good day, everyone. This is the Youth Department from the Mavis Bank Seventh-day Adventist Church with our tribute for the late Sister Beverly Edwards in the form of a poem by Rhonda Braswell. God saw that you were tired, and the cure was not to be. So he put his arms around you and whispered, go to sleep. With teary eyes we watched you suffer and saw you fade away. And although we loved you dearly, we could not make you stay.
A golden heart stopped beating, hard-working hands at rest. God broke our hearts to prove he only takes the best. It's getting lonesome here without you. We miss you more each day. Life doesn't seem the same since you've gone away.
You never said you were leaving. You never said goodbye. You were gone before you knew it, and only God knew why. A million times we needed you. A million times we cried. If love alone could have saved you, you never would have died. In life, we loved you dearly. In death, we love you still. In our hearts, you hold a place that no one could ever fill.
My hallelujah belongs to you. 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 You deserve it. You deserve it.
could not be here. John saw the city. Oh, yes, he did.
John caught a glimpse of the golden throne. Tell me all about it. Go right on around the throne. He saw the crystal seas. There's got to be more. What will it be? I want to go to the city he saw, New Jerusalem.
The blood that Jesus shed for me way back on Calvary. Oh, the blood that gives me strength from day to day. It will never lose its power, for it reaches from day to day. It will never lose its power.
The army of Judah was paralyzed by fear. When they heard a mighty multitude was quickly drawing near. But as they prayed for deliverance, the victory would begin. For when we called upon the Lord, we summoned all of heaven.
I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. And all our lives he has been faithful. And all our lives he has been so, so good. With every breath that she was able, oh, she would sing of the goodness of God.
Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me.
You made a way when my back was against the wall. and it looked as if it was over. You.
I'm here because I like to sing, and you all know I love to sing. And the song that I'm going to sing for you today is Wonderful, Merciful Savior. And I hope you find comfort in the words of this song. Wonderful, merciful Savior, precious Redeemer and friend. Who would have thought that a man would rescue the souls of men? Oh, you rescue the souls of men. Counselor, Comforter, Keeper, Spirit we long to embrace. You offer hope when our hearts are hopelessly lost away. Oh, we hopelessly lost away. You are the one that we praise. You are the one we adore. You offer hope when our hearts are hopelessly lost away. Oh, we hopelessly lost away. Almighty infinite Father, faithfully loving our all, here in our weakness you find us falling before your throne. Oh, you're falling before your throne. You are the one that we praise. You are the one we adore. You offer hope when our hearts are hopelessly lost away. Oh, we hopelessly lost away. You are the one that we praise. You are the one we adore. You give the healing and grace, or hearts always hunger for. Oh, hearts always hunger for. You are the one that we praise. You are the one we adore. You give the healing and grace, or hearts always hunger for. Oh, hearts always hunger for. Thank you for listening. Mwah. Bye. And be safe. Be safe. Be safe. I love you all.
We'll now have the reflection by Patricia Jacobs, followed by tributes, Shamar Shakespeare's son, Peter Edwards' brother, Grayson cousin, and the Merry Brothers.
Beverly Suzanne Edwards, mother of one special child, but a loving, caring Aunt Bev to the little ones who knew and loved her. For anyone who has ever visited Mavis Banks Seventh-day Adventist Church, you could not miss her. Always present, always singing. worshiping with her since 2004, I found her always ready and willing to lead out in a joyful song service. It was later called praise and worship, which she preferred because the choruses awakened in her a more responsive chord. My preference then and now is still the old hymns of Zion. However, whatever the choice, she was always ready to oblige with number 633. So much so that one day I tried to remind her of the other 600 hymns. She was fully aware of that, but her favorite was 633. She did not take too kindly my comment, but we got past that. She was not one to bear a grudge, and once she expressed her feelings, she would move on as happily as before. From 2018 onwards, I saw her more focused, more serene, more spiritual. One of the things she put behind her was her liking for jewelry, but as time went on, it became the adornment of a surrendered heart. She was always sure to attend our Wednesday afternoon prayer sessions and did her best to strengthen and support others. Many of us will be forever indebted to her family because it was her grandfather, Mas Jakey, who provided our church with the second place of worship in the community. We have fond memories of the lusty singing or SDA hymns coming from the alley. It is no wonder that singing became so much a part of her, of Bev's life. It is difficult to believe that she has left us. She sensed that her departure was coming when she said to me, as I sat with her on the morning of that day when she was taken to the hospital, "Sister Jacobs, I am not feeling well. I believe the kidneys are finished. I am confident that she settled her account with our Savior. While we can no more sing with her that beautiful special hymn, we wait for that day soon when, if we remain faithful, we shall join together with her and others who have gone before on the sea of glass to sing of the wondrous love of Jesus."
Mommy, my mom was always the driving force in my life. It's not easy. It's not easy for me. But I know that one day, if you live the right life, I'll see you again, mom. One of the biggest lessons my mom always taught me was about image. Image in that I was always someone who has to go to church every Saturday with my mom. At one point, I think that I was in hell because I think that it was just too much church. But afterwards, I realized that church was the best thing. And I favored my mom in journeying to church with her every Saturday. I realized that what she taught me wasn't in vain. She taught me about the weapon of prayer. She taught me about kindness, love, especially respecting women. She told me that women were always going to need them until the day we left, until we leave this earth. We must always honor women. Therefore, my mom, as a queen and as a son of a queen, I always respect mom, you know? It's just dawned on me that it's too soon. Things just happen sudden, you know? My mom was there for me. She was the mom who fathered me. And I must say, that's a big appreciation for me. Mom, sleep on. My mom was always a lady who loves to sing. Every Saturday she would sing on the choir at church. You know, she always want me to do a collab with her because she just loves singing, you know. And I sing with mom at home, but I never really like singing with mom at church, you know. But one day I hope that if we live the right life, I know that one day we'll see each other again and we'll sing together in heaven. Mom, sleep on. I really miss you. It's not easy. It's not easy. I miss you, Mom. Your memories will always be forever in my heart. Love you.
Why my love sister, you know, she just pass off gone. Leave me and my daughter. My daughter love her, you know, cause she educate my daughter. Enough time my daughter go in from the bed at evening time and I see her. My daughter say, Daddy, me miss me, miss Auntie, you know. I don't see my auntie at time. I say, boy, my daughter, I say, going a part of life. It's all good.
Good evening, everyone. The famous poet Henry Wadsworth Longfellow said, and I quote, "Lives of great men all remind us we can make our lives sublime and depart and leave behind us footprints on the sands of time." This, I think, epitomizes my cousin Bev, as we affectionately called her. She had a big heart. She wanted to see all the children in her community achieve success. She would share with me and say, "Auntie Grace Ann," as she called me. The parents don't have it now, but I still tell them to send the children anyhow, and when they have it, they'll pay. Most recently, during the COVID, we would speak more regularly, and she would show me how she had set up the area for them to work. Bev was so proud of the achievements and would take pictures and send, showing the students' work. One experience she shared with me was when she began teaching at the church school in Mavis Bank. She said, "One day, Auntie, I was working with the children and the principal came into the classroom. And when she saw what I was doing, she said that it was a little too advanced for their age. So I had to adjust what I was doing with them." But she said one day she heard two children cursing, and when she heard the words that they were using, she said to herself, "If they can use those words, learn those words, they can learn how to spell." Bev said, "Auntie, I took them out of the classroom and went on that tree where no one could hear me. And I taught those students over the period over 80 words that they spelled at graduation, and they were given a standing ovation for it. And I was complimented on that great achievement." That made Bev very proud. Bev really had a special gift for teaching. Bev loved her family, especially her one son, Shamar, Joval or Joe, as she affectionately called him. She was proud of his achievements and would encourage him to hold his head up high and hold on and not give up in the voice note she sent to me when he was feeling discouraged that he graduated and did not pick up a job in his field as yet. Recently, Bev renovated her home and she would send videos to show how it was progressing, and she enjoyed including Joval in it, showing him assisting the builder, and would say, "Joel learned the work in the auntie, and he's helping to cut down some of the costs." I recall on February 21, she sent two clips of Joval's farm and told me, "Auntie, let me show you what Joval planting to occupy his time while he was applying for jobs and awaiting responses." Again, on February 27, she recorded Joval, her one son, doing the welcome at church that brought so much joy to her heart. "Joval, I just want you to know that your mom was proud of you. And so I implore you to continue to hold your head up high and continue to make her proud. Hold on to her legacy. I know that would have been her desire." October 2020, when I came to Jamaica to lay my mom to rest, Bev and Pishi came to Mandeville and spent 2 weeks with us. She was so happy, and she would say, "Auntie, You know how much I love you and we would share fond memories that we shared together that brought her so much joy and laughter. Bev would say, Auntie, me no want put you in no stress in us. So sometimes I just keep what's going on to myself and try and manage. Who would have known that would have been the last time I would have seen Bev? As she rode off in the car before going and she sat in the car, Bev has a way to humor herself. And she said, Auntie, you think this car going to make it to Kingston? Look on how one side of it gone down already. And we laughed about that. Bev's heart was larger than life. Bev loved her Lord, family, school, church, and the community. I will miss her calls, videos, smiles, laughter, singing, her great sense of humor, her elegant dressing, and her posts on social media, not to mention the hairdos that they say we both are so much alike with, always changing. Bev, just know you have fought a good fight. You have finished the race. You have kept the faith. Now there is in store for you the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to you on that day, and not only to you, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. Sleep on, my dear cuz. Sleep and take your rest. See you in that getting up morning. Thank you so much.
Our second lesson is taken from Revelation 22, verse 1 through 7. And he showed me a pure river of water of life, clear as crystal, proceeding out of the throne of God and of the Lamb. In the midst of the street of it, and on either side of the river, was there the tree of life, which bare 12 manner of fruits, and yielded her fruit every month. And the leaves of the tree were for the healing of the nations. And there shall be no more curse, but the throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in it, and his servant shall serve him. And they shall see his face, and his name shall be in their foreheads. And there shall be no night there. And they need no candle, neither light of the sun, for the Lord God giveth them light, and they shall reign forever and ever. And he said unto me, these sayings are faithful and true. And the Lord God of the holy prophets sent his angel to shew unto his servants the things which must shortly be done. Behold, I come quickly. Blessed is he that keepeth the sayings of the prophecy of this book. There ended a portion of God's holy word. Amen.
All right, so that lovely song that was just sung by the Merry Brothers, Sister Johnson. You know, I can just imagine Sister Bev sitting there at the front, you know, hearing this lovely music.
And she would be speaking about the bass.
Man, and even if it's in divine service, you would hear her encore. That's exactly how much she had a passion for music. So much that she saw it fit to join the East Jamaica Conference Mass Choir, and the director, Sister Addis Jonas, would like to send her greeting, followed by Norman Smith, and then we will take the eulogy from Ruth and Bradford Cousin.
It is with mixed feelings that I stand here this afternoon to express heartfelt condolences to the family of Sister Beverly Edwards, a member of the Mavis Bank Seventh-day Adventist Church, one who has shunned using her talents of singing and her gift of imparting knowledge to young minds for many, many years. Sister Beverly Edwards was a member of the Mavis Bank Music Department. She used her talent to sing for the Lord. Over 10 years she has been ministering in that particular way. We give God thanks for her ministry. Our paths crossed in 2019 when the East Jamaica Mass Choir was rebranded. Sister Edwards answered the call like hundreds of others who showed up for rehearsals week after week after week after week, preparing for countless events. The East Jamaica Conference's Mass Choir, for which I serve as the director of the music department of East Jamaica Conference, we mourn her loss in a very, very profound way. When I learned of her passing, it really, really shook me, because we have been losing quite a few members from the Mass Choir. And Sister Edwards's loss has left an indelible mark in our lives. It has left a deep hole. But we know for sure that her faith was resolute and founded in the Lord. And so we know that in the great getting up morning, if we remain faithful, we will see her again. We want to, from the conference level, express to the family at this time our deepest and sincerest condolences. And we want to let you know that the administration also stands with you in expressing their condolences to the passing of Sister Edwards. Continue to remain faithful. We will miss her. We'll miss her deeply. The choir will never be the same again. But we rest assured in the fact that Christ is the resurrection and life. And because she believed in him and she remained faithful, if we remain faithful, we too will see her. Rest assured, family, we are praying for you. God bless you and strengthen you as you go through this very difficult period. Our prayers remain. God bless.
Above all,
Praise the Lord, church. Brethren, when you see me worshiping like never before, I know that this morning was it me, and I know it's the first you people see me perform like that. You know why? Well, worship God like that. You know why I was all worshiping the Lord this morning? I know my miracle. I was a dead being twice last week, Sabbath. Sister Kristen asked me to do a special. And Jennifer asked me to help with the song service. And Martha, I practiced like never before. Come and say, me, I go worship God last week, Sabbath. I called Brother Alex and I said, Brother Alex, you have to come help me tear down Satan's kingdom. He was here. People, brothers and sisters, I got up all perky. I took out the clothes that I promised to wear the Sabbath, last week, Sabbath. And all energetic and everything. And when I went to the, I felt, when I took out the clothes out of the closet, I felt myself being nervous, you know. But I study my body. I'm a diabetic and I'm a hypertensive. So I study myself. Whenever I get shaky, I know that my blood sugar is very low. Anyhow, Joval was outside doing something, and I called him, and he said, soon come. And I said, Joval, you see me got dead in here, and you not come. I said, come no man. When he came, I said, Joe, got me sweeten some sweet sugar and water, sugar water for me. And when he carried the spirit, you know, man, you must listen to the spirit, you know. The spirit said, Bev, test your blood sugar first. Remember, you know, when my sugar is low, I am normally nervous. And the spirit said to me, do not drink that sugar water. Test your diabetes, your sugar level first. When I tested, it was 9. I said, okay, that's good. But why am I shaking? Me, I talk to myself, you know, and me afraid to see me come. I said, no, man. All my heart has stopped. I could not breathe. When I test my blood pressure, it was people. I am a standing miracle. It was 290 over 190 heart rate, 144. You know, say, I strokes that and death. I was there and I said, oh my God. Normally when I come into church on a Sabbath, I don't eat breakfast. I don't know why. So Joval was preparing my lunch to take and he put it in the lunch bag and everything. So I took my medication, the spirit had talked to me something, and listen, you know, the spirit said, Bev, take all your medication. I did. And it said, swallow 4 aspirin. I did not at the same time, I only chewed 2. And I started relaxing myself and drink some water. And Joval monitoring the blood pressure reading. It was going down rapidly, the heart was going down. 76, I go down, you know, I said, God, if my heart rate drop, oh, me, I go build it back. He said, keep calm. I said, okay, calm. People, I felt in the right range. I got up, I feel good, you know. And I went to the bathroom and I bathed. And I went in and put on my clothes, you know. And I stood in front of the mirror. And I was titivating up, getting all pretty and everything. And the same thing come, worse than ever. I said, I could not breathe. I was dead. When I test my pressure, it was 290. Over 195 heart rate, 150. And my testimony, you know, says when me come up this morning, and me a worship, I'm in a see nobody, help me worship. And look here, I was there, you know, and I test my pressure. I test, keep on, Jehovah said, Bev, swallow 2 more. Remember the spirit said, swallow 4. But me still never take the 2, because me say, if I take the 2 and it go down, I could either dead or something. So the spirit said, drink some water, Bev. Relax. Don't panic. Drink some water. And I came right back. And Joval said, Bev, don't go to church. I said, Joval, me I go in the car. Guess what? I never want me stay back here. Me not stay. Me I go. Joval said, Bev, relax. He said, okay. The spirit said, Bev, follow your son. Because if you get up and start walking, you might back in the same thing. And God is so good. Here am I worshiping God. So me now watch nobody. I am with my Lord, because I could be dead. Praise the Lord in the moment, because you can't, listen, you will be here today and gone in a second. So let us praise the Lord. Thank you.
The blood that Jesus shed for me way back at Calvary. It was the blood that gave me strength from day to day. It will never lose its power. Let me do that for you one more time. The blood that Jesus shed for me way back at Calvary. It was the blood that gave me strength from day to day. It will never lose its power. To the heart. Oh, it was the blood that gave me strength from day to day. It will never lose its power. It soothed my doubt and calmed every fear. And it dries, yes, it dries up all my tears. Oh, it was the blood that gave me strength from day to day. It will never lose its blood. And it reaches, oh, and it reaches to the highest mountain, and it flows to the lowest valley. Yeah, it was the blood that gave me strength from day to day. He will never, never, never lose its power. Just help me sing the chorus. And it flows to the lowest valley, yeah, and reaches to the highest mountain. Oh, yes, it was the blood that gave me strength from day to day, and will never, never, never lose its power, and will never, never, never lose its power.
Amen, amen, amen. Bless the
Praise
Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Come on, Sister Bev. Sing it one more time. Sing it one more time, Sister Bev. Come on, lift us as we sing together. Sing it one more time. Lift the blood.
The blood that Jesus shed for me way back at Calvary. Oh, it was the blood that gave me strength from day to day. It will never lose its power, and it reaches
everybody.
To the highest mountain.
Come on, let us stand and worship. Come on, let us stand in the house. And it flows.
And it flows to the lowest valley.
If you believe it, sing it.
Yeah, it was the blood.
Only his blood.
That gave me strength.
From day.
From day to day.
Oh, if you believe it, you never lose.
Never lose. For it reaches
me
to the highest mountain.
Oh, church, sing that song.
Hallelujah. Oh, and it flows.
Oh, yes, it flows
to the lowest valley.
Oh, that blood.
Yeah, it was the blood
that gives me strength.
That gives me strength.
strength.
From day.
From day to day, he will
never lose.
He will never lose. He can never lose.
It's power.
It pours.
Lift your hands and praise the Lord. Come on. Lift your hands and praise the Lord. Give him the highest praise. Give him the highest praise.
I will be eulogizing the life of Beverly Susanne Edwards. Petals bloom, and when they fade, they leave a lasting fragrance with those who touched them or were touched by them. The petal Beverly Susanne bloomed in October 28, 1974. She was the first delightful bloom of the late Oswald and Evelyn Edwards. The lush vegetation of Mavis Back caressed her for the first 3 years of her life. Then she was transplanted to Mandeville to further develop. She attended Westminster College Preparatory School and then completed her secondary education at Mona High School, where she entered many a music festivals. Beverly's fragrance was always captivating and permeated the air wherever she was. Her sweet aroma was evident in her home and extended to her community and church and wherever she worked. Beverly's fragrance filled each room with her caring, tender touch. As the first female offspring, she early learned to do chores and take care of her younger siblings, developing the art of homemaking and cooking skills. As she continued to bloom, she grew and developed into a much more mature and delightful petal, blossoming and giving birth in 1995 to her one and only son, Shamar Shakespeare, affectionately known as Joval. And oh, how he added joy and laughter to her life. As a single mother, she worked tirelessly to see to his well-being. With limited resources, she engaged and encouraged him to be the best that he could be. She believed in him and sacrificed everything to give him her best. One of her brightest blooms was in 2019, when her son graduated from the Maritime University with a Bachelor of Engineering in Industrial Systems. Beverly bloomed wherever she was planted. She was industrious, hardworking, and with good work ethics, no work was considered menial. After leaving high school, she went to hairdressing school, but was unable to get a job in her trade, so she worked as a domestic help for many years. She also worked as a handy chef at the Mavis Bank High School, where a lot of the students enjoyed her cooking because they were tasty and generously served. However, Bev had a passion for education, in particularly teaching, which led her to start Auntie Bev's Evening School, where she taught not only children but adults as well. Her last work assignment was a class teacher at Miracle Kindergarten SDA School in Mavis Bank. Her students and colleagues alike were impacted by her sweet fragrance and continue to mourn her passing. In 2000, Beverly offered up herself as a sweet aroma to the Lord in baptism at the Mavis Bank SDA Church. Despite the struggles and temptations, she remained focused on her commitment to God. Blessed with the melodious gift of singing, she used her gift to minister and could always be seen leading praise and worship or music of meditation. She also had a song in her heart and a prayer on her lips. Her life was indeed a sweet aroma for God. Beverly's life was full of overflowing, one filled with struggles, ill health, and limited finances. Yet one lives unselfishly for her family and community, always seeking ways and means to help the less fortunate in the community. She modeled obedience and trust in her God and eternity. In one of her last voice notes, it was clear that her sweet aroma of faith had not changed even as her trials lingered, failing health. Her faith was anchored in Christ Jesus. Sadly, on February 26, 2021, her petal began to fade, and she was rushed to the hospital where she was diagnosed with renal failure and later succumbed to her illness on March 10, 2021. But her fragrance still lingers on in the hearts of those who mourn her passing. Her son, Shamar, sister, Nadine, brothers, Lando, John, and Peter, nieces and nephews, and a host of other relatives and friends. Rest in peace until we see again.
The good afternoon again, everyone. The task is mine at this moment to introduce to you the speaker of the hour. I believe he needs no introduction. He served as a pastor for the district some years ago, and by now, I believe that he is family. He's no other than Kevin White, but before he comes, we'll have a musical item by Danielle Brown.
Presence of the Holy One. family, especially to Joval. God is still on the throne, and he still cares for his own. I'll you for the next 14, 1 to 6. Let not be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas saith unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh to the Father but by me. Let not your heart be troubled. Gracious God, we thank you for the God who you are, and the fact that you are still alive. As we come to comfort each other, bless this word to our hearts this evening, in Jesus' name. In times of sorrow, brothers and sisters, we instinctively turn to God's word. For in God's word, we find comfort and we find solace. And very often, we turn to this passage of scripture. It has dried more tears, strengthened more hearts, and graced more funerals, perhaps more than any other passage, including that of Psalm 23. To be sure, Jesus spoke these words. He spoke it in the upper room, on the eve of his crucifixion. His intention was to comfort the troubled hearts of his disciples. For the last verse of John 13 was a very troubling prediction to Peter. Will you lay down your life for my sake? Most assuredly, I say to you, the rooster shall not crow till you have denied me three times. We know, and Jesus knows, that we are frail, fallible human beings, and we are often filled with confusion, shame, guilt, and sorrow. Jesus knows, and in his very next word, he gave this reassurance. There is a peace that Jesus provides. And that's why he says, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. He's telling us that we can take charge of our hearts. We can take charge of our emotion and our attitudes. He's commanding us to let nothing trouble us. Nothing externally should trouble our hearts or to disturb the peace that Jesus gives. There is a place that Jesus has gone to prepare. He is here promising us a home in heaven. The old versions of the text used to say, Jesus is preparing for us a mansion. And some of the other new translation uses other words. But even the smallest dwelling place in heaven will be far greater than the finest mansion on earth. And furthermore, Jesus Christ promised that he will return to earth, a promise that Paul amplifies in 1 Thessalonians 4, 13 through 18. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God. Even as we celebrate this Easter period, we are reminded that not only that Jesus died on the cross, but that he rose again and he is alive. We serve a risen Savior. He's in the world today. We know that he is living, no matter what men may say. And so because he lives, we can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fears are gone. Because I know he holds the future, and life is worth a living just because he lives. There is a place that Jesus has gone to prepare for us. Then thirdly, there is a path that Jesus prescribes for us. In John 14, 5-6, the last two verses of this paragraph warn us that every road doesn't lead to heaven. There's only one way, one road, one plan of salvation. And Peter later puts it this way, nor is there salvation in any other, for there is no other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Friends of mine, today, as we go through our moments of bereavement, we need the peace that Jesus provides. We are eager for the place that Jesus is preparing, and we need to ensure that we're on the path that Jesus prescribes. Oh, friends of mine, one of these days, death will die. One of these days, there'll be peace in the valley. The marketplace will be empty. No more traffic in the streets. All the builder's tools are silent. No more time to harvest wheat. Busy housewives cease their labors. In the courtroom, no debate. Work on earth is all suspended as the king comes through the gates. Happy faces line the hallways, those whose lives have been redeemed, broken homes that he has mended, those from prison he has freed, little children and the aged, hand in hand stand all aglow, who were crippled, broken, ruined, clad in garments white as snow. I can hear the chariots rumble. I can see the marching throng. The flurry of God's trumpet spells the end of sin and wrong. Regal robes are now unfolding. Heaven's grandstands all in place. Heaven's choir now assembled start to sing Amazing Grace. The King is coming. The King is coming. I just heard the trumpet sounding, and now his face I see. The King is coming. The King is coming. Praise God, he's coming back for me. Soon and very soon, we will reunite with our sister Beverly. Very soon, the mossy old graves where the pilgrims sleep shall be opened as wide as before, and the millions who sleep in the mighty deep shall live on this earth once more. Oh, we see the glimpse of the golden morning, piercing through this night of gloom. Oh, we see the glimpse of the golden morning that will burst the tomb. I am happy to tell you that one of these days we are going to have a grand reunion with all the sleeping saints and with all God's children throughout earth remotest bound. I charge you, be faithful. I charge you, be strong. Be of good courage. One of these days, our Lord will come and will not keep silent. And we will live and reign with him throughout the ceaseless ages of eternity. For God himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. And so, brothers and sisters, family members, I encourage you to be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Let us be faithful. Let us carry on. Let us fight the good fight of faith, that when the work on earth is done, and when we meet in that celestial city, when we will be reunited with our parted brothers and sisters, may we be able to say, Lord, this is our God. We have long waited for him, and he has come to save us. May God bless you. May God strengthen you. May God give you coping grace as you meet this dark and trying moment. May God bless you.
Amen and amen. Thank you so much, Pastor White. Powerful words coming from the man of God, directly from the throne of God. As we are winding down, we're going to take a few more tributes coming from Sister Losharna Miller from the Content Gap Seventh-day Adventist Church, and then Sister Altora Anderson from the Hagley Gap Seventh-day Adventist Church, and then we'll have Sister Rosemary James Cousins.
I'm only a pilgrim and stranger in this unfriendly world that I roam. When Jesus has brought me from darkness, has promised me an heavenly home. In the Bible we speak of the city's builder and ruler is God. And someday when this life is over, it's a beautiful sight we behold. I'm longing for where the sun go at down. I want to go where sweet rest can be found. I'm just about through with the sorrows of clay. I'm leaving glory someday. When the last weary mile has been traveled and the gates of the city sing wide, oh, to that city I'm going, behold the Savior to see. Sun go at dawn. I want to go where sweet rest can be found. I'm just about through with a sort of self-clay. I'm leaving this world. Oh, for glory someday.
Tribute for Sister Bev's family. Those we love remain with us, for love itself lives on and on. Cherished memories never fade because your loved one is gone. Those we love can never be more than a thought, for as long as there are memories, they live on in our hearts, protected with all the love we have to give. We are floating down the stream of time. We have not long to stay. The stormy clouds of darkness will turn to brightest day. Then let us take courage, for we are not left alone. The lifeboat soon is coming to gather his true will soul. Then cheer, my brother, cheer. Our trial soon be o'er. Our loved ones we shall meet upon the golden shore, where pilgrims and we're strangers here, we're seeking a city to come. The lifeboat soon is coming to gather his true will soul. The lifeboat soon is coming, by the eyes of faith I see. As she sweeps through the waters to rescue you and me, and land us safely on the port with friends we love so dear. Get ready, cries the captain, oh look, she's almost here. Then cheer, my sisters, cheer. Our trial soon be o'er. Our loved ones we shall meet upon the golden shore, where pilgrims and we're strangers here, we're seeking a city to come. The lifeboat soon is coming to gather his true will soul. The lifeboat soon is coming to gather his true will soul. Sister Bev.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am truly grateful for this opportunity to give my tribute to my dear friend, Beverly Edwards. Before I begin, I must say condolences to the bereaved family of Sister Bev. I pray and hope that God will be with you and to strengthen you throughout the day. Auntie Bev, myself go back a way back. Yes, I think we knew each other for over 18 years. Yes, we have been friends for over 18 years. We have our good times and our bad times. At times, we even fuss and fight, not there fight, but we have our conflict. But we never let that get between us. In fact, we never keep malice. No matter what happened, we never keep malice. A time when she, you know, Auntie Bev loved to use her mouth and she would chat and chat. And I said, before I can chat, so she would say, let me chat. The next thing, somebody will go back and say, we never say. You know, or she still, she's just playing like that. She would just talk her mind. What you see is what you get in Auntie Bev. She's such a warm, loving, caring person. I'm telling you. She will give us our last for somebody. I tell you. She's really, really kind. If you see her there that don't have it, she will try her best to get it for you. Yes. She have a tender spot for people. She have a spot for children. Yes, children love Auntie Bev and she love them too. Boy, Auntie Bev. She's a motivator. She's a motivator. You ever see her on the road with the young people them? She always say, come here man, come here. What you do? A smoke, yeah, smoke? You know what, something better with her life. She's like that. She's a warm person. She's a child-friendly person. The children love Auntie Bev and Auntie Bev love them. Boy, I'm going to miss Auntie Bev a lot. I'm telling you. When I heard of her passing, it really hit me because of the last time I saw her. It was communion day at church and we were about to go home. As usual, we both walk Saturday evening to Mavis Bank and she...
You make a way. When my back was against the wall and it looked as if it was over, you.
All right, so with all the good singing and the wonderful tributes in words to the family of Sister Bev, you know that we can't do anything without prayer. The family definitely needs our prayers at this time. So we will be having the prayer for the bereaved family by Sister Shireen Walker at this time.
Most righteous and adoring Father, we praise you, we honor you, and we give you thanks for this occasion where, Lord, we come to pray for our dear sister who have passed, for the members that left behind, the family members that leave behind. Lord, we ask you that you will be with them in a very special way. We know it is not easy to lose someone, especially someone that is very loving and kind. And so, dear Father, we ask of you, please, that you will just be especially with the son, knowing that his mom is gone, she will never to be seen again. Lord, we pray that you'll be his comfort, his guide. We pray, dear Father, that you will never leave him. You will continue to guide him in your truth. So that, Lord, when that day should come, when you will be coming for your people, he too will be caught up to meet you. And he will be able to see his mom. I pray, dear Father, for a special covering over him to prevent him from leaving you, Father. I pray that you will hold him with your right hand. And as you hold him, dear Father, I pray that you will educate him in you. Because, Lord, it doesn't matter the education that we get, your education is the better one. So I ask of you, please, that you will be with him. Guide him, dear Father. I pray that you'll be with the sister, the brother that leave behind. I pray that, dear Lord, they will follow in her footsteps, knowing that she have accepted you as a Lord and Savior from sin. And they are not to hope as if one without hope, dear Father. But I pray, dear God, that you'll be with them in a special way. And you'll continue to guide them and protect them. And as I have said before, that they will follow into her footsteps to worship you and to adore you and to bless your holy name, for you are worthy to be praised. I pray for peace among them. I pray that there will be no rift, no bad living, but Lord, they will live lovingly and kind. And as they live, dear Father, they will remember to exalt you, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the conquering Lion of the tribe of Judah, because you are a merciful God. And so, Father, as I pray for them, I pray that you just cover them under your blood. Be with their going out and their coming in. And I pray that, dear Lord, you will see all of them through. Be with them at such a time like this. Dear Father, it is not easy. But I beg of you that you will comfort them in every way. And Lord, I ask that as you comfort them, you will help them to give their life completely to you. Thank you, Father, for hearing and answering my prayer, as I ask of you this evening through your Son, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. Amen.
We want to thank you for joining us this afternoon as we celebrate the life of Sister Beverly. On behalf of the Edwards family, on behalf of the Mavis Bank SDA Church and the Mavis Bank District of Churches, we want to thank you for joining us. You could have been elsewhere and you were here with us. I want to implore you as you go that you do not mourn. Keep her legacy alive. She was a jovial individual, and I'm sure she wouldn't want to see us moping around. So keep her legacy alive. Sing if you can, and remember to keep your families and your friends. Tell them you love them, because at the end of the day, we don't know what is going to happen and when it is going to happen. So we thank you again for joining us. And before you go, remember to like, subscribe, and share our page. Have a good evening. And I'm sure Sister Bev would want you to do the same too. So before we go, we'll have the closing prayer by Brother Clyde Jacob, Elder Jacobs.
Loving Father, we truly want to thank you another time, Lord, for being with us and for this program that has gone forth in tribute to our dear Sister Bev, Auntie Bev. Lord, we continue to celebrate her life. Lord, we thank you for giving her to us. Lord, we thank you for the time that we spent together in worship and fellowship. Lord, we thank you that she gave her life to you in due season. Lord, we have hope, Lord, that one day in that great getting up morning, that we will be with her marching into the New Jerusalem. Lord, until then, we ask that you will continue to strengthen us. Help us, Lord, to be faithful. Lord, remember her son and the rest of her family. Lord, may they follow in her footsteps to know you as Lord and Savior, that there will be a reunion on that great getting up morning. Lord, bless us to this end. Keep us true. Keep us faithful, Lord. Until that day, we pray, saying thanks in Jesus' name.
All right, everybody going to sing with me now, right? We're going to praise the Lord as we know best, don't it? We're going to lift him up and we're going to sing, because my hallelujah belongs to him, all right?
My hallelujah belongs to you. 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 Let me hear you shout it. You deserve it.
Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What a way to end this day praising. Hallelujah. Glory. The enemy is defeated. Hallelujah. The enemy is defeated. Sometimes the enemy, he riding like a flood with all sort of sickness. But today we are claiming victory. Victory. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, sister. Victory. Hallelujah. The enemy is defeated and we claim victory. Thank you, Jesus. Your hallelujah. All hallelujah. All hallelujah. All praises. Hallelujah. Belongs to you, oh God. Thank you. Thank you for hearing our prayer. Thank you for delivering us. And everyone that is in here is covered under the blood of Prince Emmanuel. Thank you for the cross, Jesus. Thank you for your precious blood. And as we go, dear Jesus, may your anointing be on us, I pray. May our face shine because we have met King Jesus and we know him. By name, amen and amen.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. When your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. People like you.
streets are made of gold. And when you get there, there's a hand to hold. There's a place up there for people like you. I know you're out there, so keep doing what you do. 'Cause there's a place up there for people like you. Mm.